Rannita Nunu Williams was a well-known interior designer and mother of three from the Shreveport, Louisiana neighborhood of Caddo Heights. Her friends and family characterized her as a cheerful and well-liked individual. Her clientele adored her, and she was very skilled at her profession. According to them, her one flaw was that she shared too much on social media, particularly Facebook. Rannita was similarly unafraid to speak her thoughts, and it would be one of the posts she made online that would be the start of a series of events that would lead to one of the most shocking crimes many in her close community and many online viewers would ever witness. Welcome to Viral Crimes. Subscribe and hit the notification bell for more stories. Jonathan Robinson was Rannita's significant other. He was raised in Shreveport, Louisiana, but just relocated to Houston, Texas. Everyone in Rannita's life first saw Jonathan as a father figure for Rannita's three children. Jonathan could also be possessive, and he disliked Rannita's willingness to stand up to him.
Women are the winners.
I ain't gonna say all men women. I'm gonna say me and my n****s winning though.
Okay, well, 10 dudes winning. Okay.
Like a mother.
Let them tell it.
Yeah, we winning.
Yeah, let y'all tell it.
We don't know how to lose. We don't imitate losses good. And nothing. I mean that, nothing.
But anyway, y'all know what it him for, women. We already know what it him for.
What?
Huh? Nothing. What?
Exactly.
To
nothing.
Be unsaid.
Nothing.
To be on top.
Exactly, nothing.
To be on top.
What if you got a 10-2? You done. Game f***ing over.
Rannita and Jonathan continued a long-distance relationship, although Rannita saw that Jonathan had other romantic interests. He was seeing a lady called Sharika in Houston, and he didn't conceal it. There were occasions when Jonathan would leave early to return to Sharika, and Rannita had grown tired of it. In the autumn of 2017, she ended a relationship to Jonathan. After her breakup with Jonathan, Rannita decided to attend a friend's birthday party and enjoy her newfound independence. During her outing, she encountered a guy who knew her cousin Trina. Trina characterized the guy as a decent individual, and soon Rannita had a new boyfriend. Rannita went public with her new romance, but she did it with caution. Jonathan was from Shreveport, and he was unhappy with her dating a new guy, despite his ability to date many women simultaneously. While she was out with her new boyfriend, Jonathan had spies text and phone her. In February of 2018, Rannita headed out with her buddies and announced on Facebook where they were. Seeing Rannita out with her friends having a great time at the club, Jonathan showed up to the same club. When Jonathan arrived at the club, he grabbed her by the neck. Jonathan's criminal history included assault and domestic violence. When he was denied what he desired, he would respond violently. In March of 2018, Sharika began discussing Rannita online. She advised her not to interact with Jonathan, since he was hers. Rannita wished to defend herself, so she went live on Facebook to discuss how Jonathan was still attempting to reconnect with her. Jonathan saw this, and since Rannita had the courage to stand up to him, he intended to punish her. Rannita, her brother, and their mother Anita were all present at home on April 12, 2018. After arriving at the house, Jonathan banged on the door and forced it open. He instantly threatened them with a rifle while brandishing it. Jonathan was informed by Anita that she would be contacting the police. That is when Jonathan fired a shot at Anita's head that narrowly missed her. She managed to get away and quickly go to the neighbor's home to make a 911 call. Rannita was instructed by Jonathan to go on Facebook Live and make apologies to Sharika. Because her account was suspended by Facebook once again, Rannita had to use her brother's Facebook account. Said Rannita, "Hey y'all, this is Nunu, I didn't have any business doing all that. My page been blocked." Jonathan is seen walking back and forth while carrying a shotgun. Eventually, Jonathan shot Rannita in the knee and shouted, "Now apologize B." Rannita apologized to Sharika. Following Renita's apology, her brother was able to flee uninjured. Jonathan shot Rannita four times and shouted B, game over and B wanna be famous, I'll make her famous. While all of this was occurring, the police came, and they engaged in an hour-long standoff with Jonathan. He fired several bullets at the outside cops. Eventually, he emerged after conversing with Sharika on the telephone. She urged him to drop the weapon and exit the room.
Tonight's top story, a bizarre scene played out in court today as the man accused of killing his ex-girlfriend on Facebook Live had to be tackled by several deputies. NBC6's Zyneria Bird was in the courtroom this morning and joins us now in studio control with details of what happened. Zyneria.
Jackie, during testimony today, Jonathan Robinson started yelling and cursing at his lawyer and even at one point jumped up out of his seat and was tackled by sheriff deputies. It happened while a homicide detective was giving an in-depth testimony of what happened on April 12th in the killing of Rannita Williams. The detective said Robinson told him that he killed Williams after forcing her to get on Facebook Live and apologized to his current girlfriend for making fun of her. Court resumed after the outburst, and Rannita Williams' family was in court and they were very emotional hearing the testimony, and the judge ruled that there is enough evidence to try Robinson for second degree murder, and Jonathan Robinson will be back in court for his arraignment on June 19th. Back to you.
All right, very bizarre. Thank you very much.
Jonathan was arrested for second degree murder, but he said he should have been charged with first degree murder. In the past, Jonathan faced legal issues. He has previously been charged with second-degree murder, armed robbery, battery, domestic violence, and assaulting a police officer, among other offenses.
A man accused of killing his ex-girlfriend on Facebook Live changes his plea to guilty today. NBC6's Delano Henry joins us now live from the Caddo Parish Courthouse with more. Delano?
That's right, Jackie. Everybody in the courtroom was in tears today as Jonathan Robinson apologized to the mother of the victim, Rannita Williams.
Live on Morse phone. No.
This was Rannita Williams on Facebook Live just moments before her Facebook friends witnessed her life being taken. It happened back in April of 2018.
I don't have to worry about it no more. My baby can rest. It's just over with and I'm glad.
And her mother, Anita, is relieved the man accused of killing her daughter is pleading guilty.
This has been the longest months of my life.
37-year-old Jonathan Robinson is Williams' ex-boyfriend. He initially entered a plea of not guilty to first-degree murder and several counts of attempted first-degree murder of police officers. According to the district attorney, two of them even came close to dying.
The officer who actually was shot and the first officer who drove up to the scene of the crime, who thankfully she stopped short, because if she had driven all the way up to the house, she would have been killed.
The district attorney tells NBC6 News before talking with Renita's mother, he did seek the death penalty.
But based on my conversations with her, I was willing to back off if he pled.
So at the end of the day, the decision that was made was my decision. We feel a lot better. It hurts me. It hurts me so bad. By killing Jonathan, it's not going to bring Rannita back. None whatsoever. So.
Robinson also pled guilty to all of the other charges and he faces life in prison without parole. Back to you.
All right, thank you very much, Delano.
Jonathan had previously acted aggressively against Rannita, a family member further said. He admitted to authorities that he shot Rannita during questioning. Even worse, he said that he had made the decision to murder Rannita that morning when he woke up. He also admitted to firing at cops in order to get them to kill him. He only surrendered because he ran out of bullets and also because his girlfriend encouraged him to. Jonathan was sentenced to life without parole plus an additional 100 years. Jonathan expressed to Renita's family, "I'm so sorry I did what I did. I know I hurt a lot of people, myself. I hope one day you forgive me for what I did." Anita told Jonathan that she already forgave him. Reportedly, Jonathan is completing his time in a Louisiana prison. What happened to Rannita was truly tragic. I'm sure she could never imagine that someone she once loved would be the one to end her life. The actions of Jonathan Robinson has affected so many lives, especially the lives of Renita's three young children. My condolences to the family. May you find healing and peace. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.